Hello class. Now in the previous lecture we have seen some of the modification need to be done in case of the SI engine in order to employ 100% alcohol as a fuel. Now I will say that some remaining modification need to be done in order to employ alcohol as 100% fuel. So the next modification need to be done in case of the SI engine, that is slow flame initiation. The problem occurred due to the slow flame initiation speed and the courage driven nature. So before that we will quick review how we will take quick review of our previous problems or previous properties of the alcohol due to which we have to make a modification in our conventional SI engines. The first one is the high octane number. We have seen already contain half the heat energy per liter as that of the gasoline, okay, that is lower calorific value. It's required less oxygen to burn the completely so stoichiometric air fuel for the alcohol is 9:1. Need to change the air fuel ratio or need to calibrate our fuel system or the carburetor, okay, to fulfill that air fuel ratio. It have higher rate of vaporization, okay, the cold starting problem. So that was the problem was we supposed to face in case of the alcohol engine, okay, alcohol SI engine, okay. So the respective modification we have to perform it. After that, the next problem with the alcohol, that is it have a slow flame initiation speed, okay, as we are talking about the spark ignition engine. So what exactly happening in spark ignition engine? During the suction stroke, both air and fuel mixture are come into the combustion chamber, means we are taking a charge into the combustion chamber, is it? So once the compression stroke ends, okay, some degree before TDC, if you remember that wall timing diagram for SI engine, that is the actual wall timing diagram of SI engine. So 20 to 30 degree or 20 to 15 degree before TDC is supposed to initiate a spark. But whenever we initiate the spark, okay, that we know why we are making advancement of a spark before TDC, okay. But ideally we supposed to have a spark at the TDC only at the end of compression stroke, but actually we are taking the advancement. So that thing we have already seen in the our previous course, that is advanced engine technology. But whenever spark gate initiate spark gate generated in between the two electrode of spark plug, that time what are the phases need to be done by air fuel jet? That is the first thing need to be done by air fuel mixture, that is first of all, that is a preparation phase, completion of preparation phase. Preparation of completion phase means what? Consider one molecule of fuel, okay, any fuel. Here we are talking about the alcohol. So we are not taking example of specific petrol or alcohol for the sake of understanding. So just consider any molecule of fuel, okay. Suppose if I am heating that molecule, okay, by hot air, so what will happen at a contact point of hot air with that molecule, fuel molecule, spark will not supposed to initiate, okay. Whenever we are supposed to expose that fuel molecule to hot environment or any flame, that time that fuel molecule first of all start to absorb heat, okay, from that heat source. Once the heat absorbed by that fuel molecule is sufficient or it reaches to self ignition temperature of that fuel molecule, at that point a visible self propagating nucleus or a visible flame, a very tiny flame, will supposed to introduce at some of the point on that molecule, okay. For example, another example, just take an example of that matchstick, okay, and you're supposed to lighten that matchstick, okay, by rubbing it on the matchbox, okay, that matchbox, that particular area on which we're supposed to have a friction. So whenever that phenomena are recorded with the high speed camera, if that phenomena, that is lightening of matchsticks with the help of matchbox, that phenomena if I record with the high speed camera, I come to know that after completion of rubbing action, okay, then also the mastic not supposed to glow. Okay, it happens due to what? Because for the reaching that molecule, that fuel molecule which is or that sulfur which is present on the mastic needs some preparation time to initiate a spark itself. Okay, so for that purpose it absorb the heat from the heat source. And in case of the mastic, what is the heat source? Friction in between mastic and matchbox, that is a heat source. And it start absorbing the heat from that friction. Okay, so when heat absorbed by that fuel is sufficient to have a visible nucleus of flame, okay, then and then only a flame front will be introduced. Okay, so similarly in case of the combustion chamber, the molecule which is located, that is fuel molecule which is located near to spark plug, first of all in case of SI engine, start to absorbing heat from that flame generated or flame from flame not flame a spark generated. Okay, it start to absorb heat from that spark generated and it start to preparing itself to till its temperature not reaches to self ignition temperature. So that phase is called as a preparation phase. Okay, preparation phase of charge. Once preparation phase is completed, somewhere on the surface of the that fuel molecule a visible flame or small nucleus of flame will initiate and that nucleus start to propagate to entire surface of that molecule. Okay, so preparation phase is there, initiation phase is there, that is initiation of self propagating nucleus. After the propagation phase is there, that is propagation of flame front. Okay, so these three phases are important during a combustion process. Whenever spark is initiated, after that these three phases are need to be complete, that is preparation of charge to reaches up to the self ignition temperature. Once it reaches to self ignition temperature, the initiation of the self propagating nucleus is there, that is small tiny spark on the surface of that fuel molecule, first fuel molecule, and once it get spread over the molecule, that one fuel molecule, after that it's supposed to share to the neighbor fuel molecule, after it further share to the another neighbor fuel molecule. So that is propagation of flame. Okay, so out of these three phase, that is preparation, initiation and propagation of flame front, after these three phases of spark generation, okay, or flame generation, the preparation phase is most important. So to complete the preparation phase before TDC is the most desired activity in case of the SI engine. And as I told you, the self ignition temperature of alcohol is much greater than our fuel, that is petrol, okay, as it octane also greater, alcohol octane is greater, but obviously it's a self ignition temperature also greater. So due to that, what happen, we have to have a more spark advancement as compared to the conventional petrol engine or petrol SI engine as compared to the alcohol SI engine. So we require a more spark advancement in case of the alcohol SI engine due to that point. So it's having a more preparation phase, it required more preparation phase because its self ignition temperature is too high, so time required to prepare that alcohol fuel molecule is much greater as compared to the time taken by the petrol molecule. Okay, so that's why we required a advancement more as compared to the alcohol as that of the petrol engine. Okay, now another thing, corrosive in nature. Yes, it contain its own oxygen, it is nothing but the oxides of alkane. Okay, if you look into the molecular formula of our alcohol, you come to know it is a just the hydroxide of our alkane group. So oxygen group with it. So such fuel, it's harmful for our fuel induction system parts. Such fuel molecules are harmful for our inlet manifold parts, our combustion chamber, our valve timing arrangement. So whenever our contact of fuel are take place with the metal part, those part get affected by such a kind of fuel. So to have protection from such a fuel, then we need to have a corrosion resistant material. Okay, all the systems are need to be coated with the corrosion resistant material. So this is another additional cost we have to bear in case of the alcohol type SI engine, alcohol fuel SI engine. So these are the modification we need to do in case of the SI. We need to adopt alcohol as a SI engine fuel. Now we will come to the CI engine modification. Okay, so as per the previous lecture, okay, or the lecture before the this session, I try to tell you the alcohol have a high self ignition temperature. Okay, in case of the SI engine, we are having a auxiliary spark in terms of spark plug. So somehow we can initiate a spark in case of SI engine, but what about in CI engine? A CI engine don't have a auxiliary spark plug. It only have a heater in terms of just in order to warm up the environment inside the combustion chamber. But rather than this, nothing is present in case of our CI engine. So everything that is spark initiation activity are done by using a high compression in CI engine. But there is a one difference in CI and SI engine. In case of the SI engine, we are only have a one flame front, only one flame front, and at only one point a very initial self-propagating nucleus generate at initial state. Once it get transformed to neighbor fuel molecule, then it get a multiple flame front. But at very initial, at only one location, flame front will initiate, that is near to spark plug in case of SI engine. But in case of the CI engine, anywhere inside the combustion chamber where a combustion favorable condition matches, at that all location a self propagating nucleus may occur. So this is the advantage of CI engine. But what to have for that? We have a high compression ratio. Okay, and as already a CI engine employ a compression ratio ranges to 16 to 18 or 60 to 20, then also at that much high compression ratio, if we supposed to use 100% alcohol as a CI engine fuel, it is not possible to have a good combustion. Okay, it may pollute environment because incomplete combustion may arise. So to resolve this issue, what we need to do, we have to use a option of dual fuel operation. Okay, so there are methods through which we can suppose to have a dual fuel operation. Okay, so here in the first method I have quoted in front of you. Okay, so alcohol is carbureted or injected into the incoming air stream into the combustion chamber. Okay, but due to the high self ignition temperature, it won't burn at the compression ratio of 16 to 80 inside the combustion chamber of CI engine. So to overcome that problem, what we can do, we have to pilot spray of diesel. Means what? We are not supposed to use only alcohol alone, we are also employing a diesel. So 100% alcohol is not there. Mean to say, primary fuel is alcohol, but to initiate alcohol combustion process, okay, we have to make a pilot spray. Pilot means, what is the meaning of pilot? It is a direction showing. Means the pilot means the such a flow, such a spray which give us at a proper objective, that is combustion of the alcohol. Okay, so as alcohol having high self ignition temperature, we need to employ a pilot spray just after the compression stroke or some degree before our compression end of the compression stroke. It is depend on the basis of the engine speed. Okay, as engine speed is increases, definitely as we are doing in SI engine, spark advancement, similarly here injection advancement also need to do. But whose injection advancement? The injection advancement of diesel spray, that is pilot spray. Okay, so due to that, what will happen? First of all, a diesel spray will supposed to initiate a spark. As the condition is favorable in diesel fuel, the compression ratio is as that they are employing in 16 to 18, and even though at the end of the compression means somewhat air is heated, so in that manner we supposed to have a favorable condition for diesel oil, and it start to readily ignite. As soon as it catches the fire, definitely whatever the charge we have introduced inside the combustion chamber through carburetor or through injector, that is alcohol, okay, it will also catch the fire. Okay, so in that way we can initiate a alcohol combustion. So here overall the percentage of diesel required is very less, because we are only injecting a diesel for the pilot purpose, and it is very initial level. Not like that throughout the span of journey I am supposed to injecting a diesel fuel, not like that, because once engine gets sufficiently warm up, okay, no need of further pilot spray. So for the sake of 10 kilometers to 20 kilometers, pilot spray may be there, okay, and after that pilot spray may not be there. After that 50 kilometer pilots may not be there. Once ECU feels the need of pilot spray is there, then it will start to again introducing a pilot spray. So it is not continuous spray. It will depend on the condition, how it is favorable with the combustion of the alcohol. Okay, atmosphere favorable of the combustion of the alcohol. So on that basis it will take a decision, and cut off of pilot spray and resuming of the pilot spray will be take place. Okay, so this is one of the thing need to be done. Another thing, that is enhancement of fineness mixture. Okay, so this is another thing need to be take care in case of the alcohol engine, that is surface to volume ratio. Okay, so what we have to do here, whenever we are initiating the pilot spray, that time what happened, heat may generate. Definitely, as I am introducing a pilot diesel spray, definitely diesel start to combust and it will develop a heat, and that get absorbed by a alcohol molecule. But if I converting the 1 liter, for example, 1 liter of alcohol, or it's too much actually, just take a few very limited volume, that 2 ml, for if 2 ml alcohol I have injected inside the combustion chamber, so 2 ml alcohol if I divided into 100 droplets, okay, then surface available to absorb that heat, okay, is comparatively less. If I divide that 10 ml alcohol into 1000 droplets, okay, if I'm dividing that 10 ml alcohol into 100 droplets, okay, then whatever the surface available to absorb that heat is less as compared to if I have 1000 droplets of 10 ml alcohol. So as I am doing a fine atomization, fineness means meant to say a finer than finer droplets if I generate for given volume of fuel, okay, then definitely surface to volume ratio will increase, and the heat developed by that pilot source, the pilot spray of diesel, get absorbed. And definitely our initiation will be, that combustion initiation of alcohol will be as readily achieved. Okay, so for that purpose, what we have to do, we have to use a high pressure nozzle, that is injector. We can use a pneumatic spray nozzle. We can use a micro fog unit also. So these are the advancements we needed. Another thing we can do here, that is surface ignition of a surface ignition alcohol C engine. As shown in the image, there is an injector which is located here, and through this injector we supposed to have a spray of alcohol alone. Okay, we are supposed to have a alcohol spray of alcohol, and that injector is a high pressure, meant to say it having a injection pressure more than 15 bar. Okay, normally in case of the SI engine fuel injection system, that is MPFI system, we supposed to employ a injection pressure up to 3 to 4 bar pressure we are supposed to employ. But here, as we required a huge micro fine droplet, so in that sense we have to use a pressure more than 10 to 15 bar. Okay, so in that range we supposed to have that injector pressure, and just below that we are having a asbestos heater sheet. So whenever these fine droplets come into the contact of that warm atmosphere, okay, that time what happened, it absorbing the heat from that asbestos sheet heater, even though the temperature generates during the compression stroke inside the CI engine by employing compression ratio 16 to 80, the heat will be sufficiently enough to have a self ignition of alcohol fuel. Okay, in that sense also we can achieve or in that sense also we can initiate a combustion of our alcohol whenever we are supposed to employ a 100% alcohol as a CI engine. So this is the another modification we are supposed to do, that is called as a surface ignition alcohol CI engine. So these are the thing we have to modify in our conventional engine. So those modification is 100% modification, means retrofit in within a few minutes. For example, once you use modify your engine for 100% alcohol, then within a next minute you can't switch your fuel option, that is I can't come back to the 100% diesel option, because whatever the modification you have here, that is permanent modification. For that purpose, for switching purpose again to the diesel, you need to be give a time. It's not like that, it is a completely a dual engine. Whenever I want, I can have a petrol or diesel, and at next instant I will have a 100%. It's not like that, like in case of the CNG engine or gasoline engine, we can say we are having a petrol tank as well as we are having the gas tank. If gas is empty, the gas tank is empty, we can shift to the petrol tank. It's not like that here. If we are employing 100% alcohol, we can't again switch to the diesel till we are not having again retrofit. Okay, so similar to the other fuel option like our hydrogen, okay, the similar our fuel option like biogas, a similar our fuel option like hydrogen, okay, and the other artificial fuel, in that cases also we need to have a modification in our conventional engine as per the properties of that fuel. As here we discussed, the alcohol have a high self ignition temperature, vaporization, latent heat of vaporization is very poor. After that, corrosion problem is there. Okay, so to handle all those property, we need to have a modification. So similarly, we have a modification for the other fuel option also. So here we have only discussed what are the modification we need to do as a alcohol 100% fuel. Okay, to have a alcohol as a 100% fuel. So I hope you have understood what OEM's roles over here. So OEMs are those who are doing a R&D on that particular part and who develop that system. Okay, so if the company or industry who developed that surface ignition technology, that is nothing but the OEM. So OEM have to work on it, and after that it's they develop the thing, they start their production, and they start to supply to well-known brands like Bajaj, Mahindra, Force, in order to assemble in their vehicle models. Okay, so main OEMs are working on those parts, on those technology. Okay, it doesn't mean like that Bajaj, Mahindra, Force or other big brand don't have their own R&D. They are also OEM for specific component. okay, but it's not like that 100% component will be developed by Bajaj their own. It's not. They are outsourcing the things to other vendors, and those vendors are OEM for that their parts, and that get given to the big brands like Bajaj, and they supposed to assemble those parts into their models. So OEM have this responsibility to develop the parts with respect to the alternate options. Okay, so I hope you you have understood what are the impact of alternate fuel option on the technology and the cost overall cost. Okay, thank you.